If you like this video, please subscribe my channel and share this video.
India set to stage an epic show with Trump as the star. Prime Minister Narendra Modi seems to have enticed Mr. Trump to fly 8,000 miles with the promise of a two-day spectacle. But serious issues remain. A poster depicting President Trump with Prime Minister Narendra Modi of India in Ahmedabad ahead of Mr. Trump's arrival. Ahmedabad, India. The roads are a hive of activity. Women hoisting buckets of sand, work crews laying down fresh tar, an army of sweepers attacking debris, and a new wall going up in front of the slum, apparently to hide it from passers-by. President Trump is scheduled to land in the western city of Ahmedabad on Monday for his first presidential visit to India, and Prime Minister Narendra Modi has planned an epic spectacle. The city is being scrubbed clean, and thousands upon thousands of Modi loyalists have been drafted to stand for hours on the sun-baked streets, there to shake flags and cheer for a president who loves nothing more than to draw a crowd. It is the second act of a budding friendship between the two men, leaders of the world's most populous democracies. Last year, Mr. Trump and Mr. Modi shared a stage in Houston at a rally called Howdy, Modi. This one is called Namaste Trump, which translates roughly as Hello Trump, but beneath the projected bonhomie lies a pricklier reality. The United States and India are strategic partners, in no small part because of a mutual concern over China, but they still can't agree on crucial issues. Even a small trade deal that was supposed to be the centerpiece of this trip has collapsed. They've been hitting us very hard for many, many years, Mr. Trump said this week of India, but he was quick to add, I really like Prime Minister Modi. Mr. Modi seems to have enticed Mr. Trump to fly 8,000 miles and spend 2 days in India by his promise to stage a huge, tightly controlled show, with Mr. Trump at its center. The president has repeatedly claimed that he has been guaranteed a crowd of 5 million to 7 million people lining the roads to greet him, and on Thursday he upped that to 10 million. Ahmedabad officials said it would be nowhere near that, more like 100,000 along the road and another 100,000 waiting for Mr. Trump in a new cricket stadium, the world's largest, where he will hold a rally. Mr. Trump is popular in India, where he is seen as a strong leader, tough on terrorism, pro-business, and friends with Mr. Modi. The two share a similar brand of divisive, populist politics. Still, Mr. Modi is taking no chances, fielding tens of thousands of police officers and packing the crowds with people he can trust to cheer enthusiastically for his guest. Just to stand along the road that Mr. Trump's motorcade will travel for a few minutes on Monday requires a special pass given to carefully vetted party members, their allies, and special groups handpicked by the government. This is a level of control Mr. Modi can deliver in India that is very different from Britain, for example, where Mr. Trump treaded carefully to avoid the optics of hostile crowds. The way the Indian government has chosen to present the visit, not as a high-powered summit meeting but as Namaste Trump, essentially Howdy, Modi Part 2, seems to signal that it may shape up as more of a public relations exercise, albeit a memorable one, than anything else for both leaders. It's a welcome distraction. Mr. Trump is eager to change the subject after his impeachment trial, and Mr. Modi would love a reprieve from protests over a new anti-Muslim citizenship law that has ratcheted up tensions between India's Hindu majority and Muslim minority. Mr. Modi has also been widely criticized for his crackdown on Kashmir, the predominantly Muslim territory caught up in a generations-long dispute between Pakistan and India. By coming such a distance to see Mr. Modi, the president will be essentially giving him a stamp of approval at a time when his leadership